So I'm guessing you put my gold in there too.
Yeah.
All right. I need to make.
I mean, I fuck around with your stuff, but I will take your stuff and put it in this place where it belongs. I just want some bookshelves because for some reason I can't find any cows near me whatsoever.
Wait,
well, it's because you're in Fear's house fucking with his shit. You're not going to find cows inside his house while you're stealing his shit.
I used up like 32 of them.
That's okay. You can turn it. No, I'm going for the tallest building in the village.
Oh, there's plenty of books. Okay.
No, don't, because the biggest building should be Angel, because he's the mayor.
Yeah, in the town.
Mind them all. I'm not counting.
It's a wood mall. It's a mall just for
wood. If it's made of wood, if it's made of wood, it would die.
I hope it burns down.
Yeah.
First floor is Exile's got wood. Second floor is Exile's ores. Third floor is
You can't sell nether goods and you can't sell... I don't know.
Hey, there people can. No, no, people... Look, people can sell whatever they want. No, you can sell whatever you want, but... If someone else is selling it, they might undersell you. You know, they're like, well, he's selling netherrack, I'm selling netherrack. Oh, he's doing it for this much? Well, I'll do it for this little. So, you know, it's part of the market. It's just some stuff is pointless to try to sell. Yeah. It's your forte, but you're not the only one, especially because if you are, that means you have to be doing pure nether mining because, you know, just on the city works.
That's just my side thing, I guess.
Yeah, I would say the best way to go about it is...
Soup is my main trade.
Yeah, okay. I would say think about really what you enjoy doing and what you can trade for stuff. But, you know, if you're the only one doing nether mining, then you're going to be doing nether mining, nothing but nether mining, because there's going to be such a high demand. And if you can't keep up with the demand, somebody else will take your market. Real world rules, people. Commerce is commerce. Can't really bend it, you know. Somebody could be like, well, I'll sell you a glowstone for 2 gold nuggets. And you're like, well, fuck, I was charging, like, you know, 5 iron blocks. It's just kind of the way it goes.
Jesus, I don't want to go to sleep yet. It's 5:39. I haven't slept at all here.
No, he was pulling an all weekender. Yeah, I try to do late night streams and 20-hour streams, but, you know, then I start to get really bad at my gaming and I just kind of zone out. And it's like, you know, I've watched a lot of, like, all-night streamers, and sometimes their streams just end up becoming, like, them, like, falling asleep in front of the computer, and it's kind of like,
I mean, I'm now just getting sleepy. So that tells you something.
Gotta get your second wind and, you know, get that nap in. You take like that an hour nap and you get back up for like 5 hours.
Holy crap, look at all this soup. Angel, check in this chest. Look at all that soup. Oh,
that's what you could trade me for the cats when you guys get cats. It's just like that one random unique item that you don't normally get. I wish you could train a cat, break it, and then give it to someone. That'd be cool.
Okay, what?
If you could, like, you know, get a cat and train it and then give it to other people.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking about earlier, actually. Like, an animal training kind of business.
Like, I mean, you're gonna have to... You can have one refill per soup I give
Lids,
you.
Lids, lice, dick!
How about that?
Thank you for the follow.
It's my fault.
The question is, do people actually, like, to burn life, thank you for the follow, do people actually, like, eat the soup, or are people just, like, collecting it?
I think Fear's just collecting it.
You got a spider eye?
No, Fear makes it to sell.
No, I'm putting it in my shop. That's my thing.
Well, no one was listening the last, like, 5 days we were playing. It's all good. It's funny, more and more people are starting to see how annoying it is that I have to repeat myself so much. cold pizza.
Anybody? Does anybody sell glass in here?
Drugs, Bunny, I think.
Nope.
Not yet.
Probably drugs.
If you want some
drugs and firepower are down in the sand.
Here, what happened to your quartz pillar in the middle of the room?
Well, I mean, also, people, don't depend on trade right now.
It's right there.
Yeah,
hold on,
drugs has got sand for sale.
I thought you said on the public works sign it said 30,000 cobble, not 10k.
Well, no, I'm starting small for now. You know, it's going
to
take us a while to get to those numbers, so no rush.
And you're climbing, by the way. You climb a ladder.
No, I mean without the painful climb of going up the mountain.
I figure we'll do cobblestone for the freeway, but we might go fancier for those.
I love being a smart ass.
Drag, drugs is he's selling and trading glass. He's doing one stack of glass for 5 iron. That's not a bad trade, really.
Where's that?
He's down in the pyramid, just down in the lower right-hand corner of the map. People, if you don't have a map, you should definitely get one going on. If you, or just kind of like start memorizing the land. I mean, not every little detail, but just the general, like, which way to the people's houses. But yeah, Drugs has got a huge, beautiful sand temple he's building. And he's definitely our MVP crafter.
Oh, he's actually building a temple?
Oh yeah, a pyramid. It's a work in progress, you know.
Well, everything here is a work in progress.
Well, I mean, it doesn't look like a temple right now, but it's definitely a work in progress. But he's down. Him and Firepower are kind of residing down in the sandy area, so those two will kind of cover sand. And of course, you know, the ocean floor, fair game. You know, if you own the coastline on your property line like me, don't take my sand off the coastline. But if you went down to the ocean floor, you know, I'm looking now at like hundreds of pieces of sand and clay. But glass takes charcoal, and it takes time. So it's definitely a commodity, and it's non-movable to one-time use.
I still need those jungle tree saplings.
Hey, why don't we just make a underground railroad? Underground train station.
This is not
underground
a slavery place. Why do we need an underground railroad?
It doesn't matter, because underneath almost everywhere on this map is giant caverns. So more than likely, you're not going to be able to dig more than like 50 or 60 or 200 blocks before you break into this big cavern. But people are welcome. People are welcome. Yeah, people could make one that goes underwater in glass tubes all the way around the coastline. That'd be cool. Like literally goes all the way around the island. Underwater. Underwater. Let's build a roller coaster. No, we got enough land. We could do a little theme park. Everyone, like, we try to build a roller coaster and try to build a ride.
That's going
to
be our last work in progress.
Dude, I just want to get the pig racetrack down the road. That's going to be fun. Four lanes, four people, four pigs, four saddles.
Cobblestone Road and the winter holes and the pig thing are the main ones right now.
Well, yeah, right now, first it's the freeway. Because I know once we get the roads done, it'll be easier for everyone to get around to do the rest of the projects. And the rest of the projects are very artsy, whereas the road is just about clear-cutting and leveling, you know, 3 wide and putting cobblestone down, and, you know, that kind of thing. So it's maybe be a lot of supplies, and it's not as artistic, but it's fun. You know, it's flattening it out and just get done. Boom, 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 boom.
Horses would still be a nice touch.
Well, that's what the road will be nice too, is we'll ride the horses really fast down them. But then, of course, you got the asshole players that are like, I'm bored, I'm just gonna go kill somebody's horse.
Like, even if it's on just computer, what if they added carts you can attach to your horses and put chests in the carts?
I still think you should be able to make a single chest with leather straps and wear it as a backpack.
Yeah.
Because it would look fine, they could easily do it. I just can't believe in almost, 5 years of Minecraft, no one sat around at Mahjong for Minecraft in general and been like, hey, let's make a backpack. Well, no, we'll have to make up. No, we'll just use the chest and some leather from a cow. Yes, of course, on PC, anything's possible because anyone can hack it, mod it, make their own patch files and stuff. But on the general game itself, like from the makers. I'm just surprised the backpack wasn't something, or horses with saddlebags.
Oh, that would be cool too. But I like the cart with the chests on it.
No, I like that one too. I'm just saying, but that's why I play Rust.
Like a fantasy immersion.
Yeah, that's why I play Rust. I mean, Rust was the most played game this year worldwide. I haven't played it in a long time, but that's just because, like I said, if I were to start playing my PC games more now on the show, almost every PS3 player would be out of their, you know, most of them aren't PC gamers that beat on the PS3. There's a few that play, like, Minecraft or something, but most of
them. How can you make a zombie village beat to come back to a regular village?
You gotta use a potion
to
make core.
Yeah. Potion of weakness, and then gold apple.
Which one? The god version of it or just regular?
I think it's just a regular gold apple.
Come on, big buddy. I'm gonna put you in my house.
But you need potions of weakness.
I got it.
Oh. Well.
Isn't that zombie flesh?
I don't know, actually. Probably look it up.
Come on, big buddy.
Google, making people stupider every year. I swear, the kid's freaking in junior high now, and his teacher in science class is letting them, like, look up on their phone stuff on Google.
Yeah, we have a bring-your-own-device program, too.
Yeah, and, of course, it's federal law. You're not allowed to do that. So, like, I made a big stink about it, and the teacher is probably going to lose his tenure and get fired, and the school's, like, fighting it, and they're like, your kid just can't afford them. I'm like, my kid's got a fucking Chromebook, an iPad mini, an iPhone, and an iPod 4. He's got plenty of devices. It's about the fact that they're looking up their answers on Wikipedia, which I can change at my own will.
We're only allowed to use it for certain things, though.
Yeah, it's just stupid. I mean, it's going to make people stupider. Taking the time to look up research
people
and have to look it up.
People are already plenty stupid. I don't think
people
can get dumber.
Every generation, they're just getting dumber and lazier, and they all think they have, like, OCD and ADD, but they're just, it's the time. It's the generation now. It's not an insult on the person. It's just, in today's world, we live in this instantaneous.
Sometimes
for people like me that finished college
it.
Yeah. People like me that finished college before the internet was invented versus people now that are like under 15 and their whole life they've just known nothing but touchscreen and instantaneous stuff. And I'm not saying it's bad or good. It's just that's something that's a big generation gap. Just like for my generation and my mom's generation, the actual computer was a big generation gap. And before her, my grandma and her, you know, shit, for a while, electricity. You know what I mean? Like, every generation. But this generation has to deal with so much information at your fingertips on your iPod while you walk down the street. That you can find porn and all these things. And I'm not saying good or bad. It's just that's something that's really unique. It's very, you know, people are generally getting stupider because they're looking their answers up on Google. Because looking things up and taking the time to look them up on paper or even research them and then read them and then have to write your own notes and you actually write something. When you actually write stuff down, it writes a layer of the 5 layers of memory engrams. You've got reading, repeating out loud verbally, hearing it verbally, writing it. And I can't remember the 5th one. There might have only been 4. But so when you're not writing it down and you're not speaking out loud and saying it and you're not hearing someone else say it, you're cutting off the possibility to write it to your brain. Doesn't mean you won't remember it or that just reading it on the internet a million times won't be a good way to implant it into your brain.
That's
but
why
actually writing stuff down.
Schools that get everything ahead of time.
Well, and then look at like how bad handwriting has become. When I was in 3rd grade, I had already learned cursive and started calligraphy. But we also had typewriter typing classes because computers weren't really in schools yet. And now it's not like a big thing on like better or worse. It's just now you look at people that are, you know, doing so much work purely typed, their handwriting. My handwriting has gotten really bad because I haven't written that much in the last couple years. I type so much. Like, even myself, as I help the kid do his schoolwork, I'm starting to remember shit I haven't used since fucking junior high and high school. And I kind of like that. I like sparking my brain up. I mean, math, I was a math major. I was intrigued in junior high. So math is usually what I study with him in science.